लास्ट लेक्चर में हमने देखा था कि इंट्रोड्यूस्ड आवरसेल्फ्स विद टर्पीन्स टर्पिनॉइड्स. वी हैव आल्सो सिंथेसाइज्ड मेवलोनिक एसिड एंड फ्रॉम मेवलोनिक एसिड हाउ वी कैन सिंथेसाइज आईपीपी एंड डीएनएपीपी. सिमिलरली वी हैड आल्सो क्लासिफाइड टर्पिनॉइड्स into hemiterpenes, monoterpenes, sesquiterpenes, diterpenes. Then we had sesterterpenes and we also had the triterpenes and then tetraterpenes. And this is based on the number of monomer units that are present. Monomer units are of two types, DMAPP and IPP. And both of them will be giving us isoprene units. So it will be giving us isoprene units like this is our isoprene unit, where if we have a double bond here and a pyrophosphate over here, this becomes a dimethyl allyl pyrophosphate. Similarly, if we have a double bond at a terminal carbon and a pyrophosphate, then this becomes a isoprene pyrophosphate or isopentenyl pyrophosphate. So these are the two our monomer units, and these two monomer units will be giving us a cation, isoprenyl cation. This isoprenyl cation will be the one which will be used to combine together in a head to tail position, so that we will have an elongated chain. If only one unit of this is coming, either DMAPP or IPP, then we call it as a hemiterpene. Two units aate hain, so it becomes a 10 carbon unit. This is a 5 carbon unit. So this is 1, 2, 3, 4 and 5 carbons are there. So if two of them are combining together in a head to tail position or a tail to tail position, then it will be forming 10 carbon compounds. That 10 carbon compound we call it as monoterpenes. Then 15 carbon compound is 3 isoprene units if they are combining together. Then it will form a 15 carbon compound that we call it as a sesquiterpene. 4 units will form 20 carbon compound as a diterpene. 5 isoprene units combining together to form a 25 carbon compound, sesterterpenes. 30 carbon triterpene and 40 carbon tetraterpenes. Today we will see about each few of them, not all of them, monoterpenes, sesquiterpenes and diterpenes we will see it. So first we will start with monoterpenes. Monoterpenes are C10 compounds which are having 10 carbon atoms can be formed by two isoprene units. By combining two isoprene units. So we can have a synthesis of this can be started with a dimethyl allyl pyrophosphate combining with or it will lose a pyrophosphate group, so that a cation will be generated over here. And this is our DMAPP. This DMAPP generates an allylic cation, which we know that it is a stable or stabilized through resonance. So we will have this allylic cation. This allylic cation then can react with another isoprene unit, isopentenyl pyrophosphate, whereby we will have an attack of this on the terminal carbon and the double bond will be shifted on the other side. So this will be our cation. So we will get this will be our first isoprene unit that we have got it from DMAPP. Then this is the bond that we formed between the two. And this one is the second isoprene unit that we have formed. Let us draw it in a black pen. This will be our pyrophosphate group. So second isoprene unit that we have drawn. Now when the electrons are going from this carbon to the earth, this will be deprived of the electrons because it is losing its electrons of the double bond. So here we will get a cation. Cation will be generated and this will form a double bond. As this electrons will be shifted over here, so this will form a double bond. And now we have here as a two protons are there. As this losing this proton can be generating a stereospecific center, so we can have this re-phase or psi-phase protons can be there. A stereospecific loss of proton will give us stereospecific loss of proton here will be our OPP. We will have a E double bond will be generated and not the Z double bond. So conformation here, this will also this is not a E or Z because the dimethyl group is present. Here it will be E double bond will be generated. This we call it as geranyl pyrophosphate. Or simply GPP, geranyl pyrophosphate or GPP. This is our monoterpene, the simplest of the monoterpene, which we can represent it in a way of a cyclic type, a pseudocyclic, not exactly a cyclic, but in a different conformation, we can represent it. This has a double bond. Here it will be a pyrophosphate, a double bond here. And this way we can write it as geranyl pyrophosphate, where this is our E double bond. So this is also a GPP. This GPP then can be further modified into different other ways. So we have GPP that we can represent it as this way. This GPP is having a E double. So this can be utilized or isomerized into simpler long chain or straight chain other other monoterpenes. Like it may lose a proton, it may lose a pyrophosphate from here. So we get a geranyl cation. This geranyl cation can then be quenched in two different ways. One, after shifting a double bond over here, a cation will be generated, at tertiary cation will be generated. This tertiary cation, we call it as linalyl cation. This linalyl cation can then take up pyrophosphate group . So it is just a position isomer of geranyl pyrophosphate. This becomes a linalyl pyrophosphate, or we call it as LPP, linalyl pyrophosphate or LPP. This is also just a position isomer for the geranyl pyrophosphate. Second way we can have is that this can be shifted over the other side. So we get After shifting, it can isomerize into another geometrical isomer. From E double bond, it can form a Z double bond. So just what is happening is, when it comes to the other one, that is allylic resonance can happen, and then the upper one bond can come downside, that is this methyl group can come downside with a cationic carbon, and we can get a flipping from E to Z isomer. So this, when it accepts a pyrophosphate group, it will be forming neryl pyrophosphate or NPP. This is our neryl cation, and upon accepting pyrophosphate, neryl cation will be forming neryl pyrophosphate. Neryl pyrophosphate and linaryl pyrophosphate are more important because they will be giving rise to, or they have an opportunity to give rise to, cyclic structures. Geranyl pyrophosphate cannot form a cyclic structure because of this ring oriented in an opposite way from the other double one. But here, the neryl cation is having a carbon very much placed nearer to a double bond over here, so that it can form a six-membered cyclic structure. And we know that five-membered and six-membered cyclic structures are easy to form and more stable also. So they can form a secondary, they can form a cyclic structures. So cyclic terpenes can be easily formed from here. Similarly, for linaryl pyrophosphate also, when loss of pyrophosphate goes, there will be an allylic cation will be there, and that allylic cation can be stabilized by this through this double bond participation of the double bond, and we can get a six-membered cyclic ring can be easily formed in this. So that way we can have cyclic monoterpenes can be easily formed. But first we will see about how geranyl pyrophosphate can be utilized for synthesis of many simple different types of compounds, terpenes, monoterpenes, which are easily available in our day-to-day life also. Like for example, we can have geranyl pyrophosphate. This GPP can reduce the double bond and then hydrolysis of this will be giving rise to an alcohol. This alcohol we call it as citronellol. Citronellol forms an important ingredient in rose oil. Rose ka jo smell hota hai, wo smell normally ye citronellol ki wajah se aata hai. Citronellol gives a characteristic smell to rose. So whatever perfume industries you have it, where rose smell is there, smell is required, or rose essence is required. So in that case, this citronellol is the one which will be required. Similarly, upon oxidation of this alcoholic group, this hydroxy group that we have it, if we oxidize it into an aldehyde, so this aldehyde will be then, we call it as citronellal. The citronellal is an important ingredient for lemongrass plant and its family. And it gives characteristic citronella oil. Citronella oil is having lot of different other applications of it, whereby it is used in perfume industry, in flavor industry, food industries, as well as this is used as a important ingredient in mosquito repellent. Citronellal is a mosquito repellent which is present in the leaves of citronella plants. Citronella plants or lemongrass plants, these are having different means their leaves will be having a characteristic compound called as citronellal, and the citronellal acts as a mosquito repellent. So all or almost all the mosquito repellents that we have, it like from Goodknight to All Out or and any other brand that you have it, they all are using this citronella oil as a mosquito repellent. The other things are being present there, but this is a main important ingredient which will be utilized for this as a mosquito repellent. So this is one and whereby we are using this citronella oil. Then we have this GPP can be hydrolyzed instead of the first reduction. If we can hydrolyze this and oxidize it by keeping the double bond intact, if we hydrolyze and oxidize it, the alcohol that we get it upon hydrolysis into a aldehyde, then this will give us geraniol. This geraniol, whereby this is having a E symmetry of the double bond. We also call it as E citral. This is an important ingredient in lemon oil. The characteristic smells of lemon oil is coming from this particular compound, geraniol. Similarly, we can have just a alcoholic group before oxidation. This will give us a geraniol. This is also an important ingredient of geranium oil. So geranium oil is a very strong, it is having a very strong antimicrobial, antifungal and antiviral activities. And it also increases the fluid circulations in the body, so that it is used in FMCG industries for skin gluing. Because skin ke niche ke jo cells hote hai, jo uska cell niche ke jo cell ki layer hoti hai, usme ye fluid ka circulations badhata hai, jiski wajah se wahan pe type ka skin ka glow aata hai. So this is a natural skin gluing agent that can be used for there. Then we have, this was for GPP, that is geraniol pyrophosphate. We can have we have a LPP, this linalyl pyrophosphate. This upon hydrolysis of this pyrophosphate will give an OH. So we can have the OH here, a tertiary alcohol. This we call it as linalool. This linalool is an important ingredient which gives a characteristic smell of coriander. So it gives a coriander oil which gives characteristic smell for the coriander leaves. Coriander means धनिया जो हम हमारे घर में किचन में जनरली यूज करते हैं. तो धनिया की जो स्मेल आती है वो स्मेल इस कंपाउंड की वजह से होती है, दैट इज लिनालूल. लिनालूल कंपाउंड की वजह से वो धनिया की स्मेल आती है, और ये स्मेल हम काफी सारे अलग दूसरे इसमें भी लेते हैं. जो हमारे एसेंसेस आते हैं, फ्लेवर एसेंसेस जो आते हैं, उसमें ये कंपाउंड होते हैं. नेचुरल इंग्रीडियंट्स नहीं होते, इन कंपाउंड को सिंथेसाइज करके वहां पे डालते हैं ताकि उनका स्मेल हमारे मिल सके. Loss of this hydroxy group, dehydration over here will be giving us myrisin, beta myrisin. Similarly, we can have neryl pyrophosphate. Neryl pyrophosphate can hydrolyze pyrophosphate to form nerol. which is an important ingredient of rose oil. It also helps in giving the characteristic smell of rose. Similarly, if we can oxidize this alcohol into an aldehyde, remember here we are not oxidizing them into acids but only up to aldehydes. So this aldehyde will be giving us neral, which is an important ingredient of lemon oil. So lemon oil will be coming from either neral or geraniol. This neral and geraniol, geraniol we had this double bond as a E double bond. Here we have a Z double bond. So this is also called as Z citral. There we had called it as Z E citral. Here we are calling it this as a Z citral. This is what is geometrical isomers of each other. So this is one where we are forming monoterpenes in an acyclic format. Acyclic monoterpenes are limited only because we cannot have much variations in this. But when we go for cyclic monoterpenes, then it will be a lot of variations we can have it. We can have a monocyclic or a bicyclic monoterpenes can be formed from that. And very many different types of compounds we can form from that cyclic and bicyclic monoterpenes. But for formation of cyclic and bicyclic monoterpenes, geraniol pyrophosphate is not useful because of its geometrical isomerism of E geometrical isomer. E double bond की वजह से वहाँ पे हम cyclization नहीं कर सकते, but linalyl pyrophosphate as well as NPP, that is neryl pyrophosphate, these two can be utilized for formation of cyclic monoterpene. So we will first see how this cyclic monoterpenes can be formed in that. So this cyclic monoterpenes can be formed from either linalyl pyrophosphate or neryl pyrophosphate. Both of them will be giving rise to this particular cation. Either a pyrophosphate loses from here or a pyrophosphate loses from here. Upon resonance resonance stabilization, it will be giving us this particular cation only. Now this cation can utilize this double bond for formation of a six-membered ring. This double bond can participate over here, so that there will be a bond formation here and we will have a six-membered ring. So this six-membered ring will be having this way, where here there will be a double bond and a cation will be generated over here. Now here a tertiary cation will be generated. This we call it as menthyl cation. Or alpha terpenyl cation. Both are one and the same thing, menthyl cation or alpha terpenyl cation. So this alpha terpenyl cation or menthyl cation can undergo very many different types of reactions. It can be loss of hydrogen or loss of proton can occur. It can abstract water molecules. It can undergo rearrangement, whereby we can have a Wagner-Mirwin rearrangement. We can go for Wagner-Mirwin rearrangement, then we can go for bicyclic formation. So it can have a different types of fates can be there. It can be quenched in very many different types of ways in which it will be giving rise to different compounds. We will see each of them, how this menthyl cation can be further utilized for generation of different compounds. First we will see the simpler ones, that is the menthyl cation can accept a water molecule. So hydrolysis, hydration of this will be giving rise to an alcohol. We call it as alpha terpenol. Alpha terpenol, and that is why this compound is also, this cation is also called as alpha terpenyl cation. So it will be giving rise to alpha terpenol. Then it can lose a proton from the terminal carbons, one of the terminal carbons, which will be giving rise to same compound. Any of the terminal carbon can lose a proton to form limonene. Limonene is an important compound which is utilized for synthesis of menthol, isomenthol, neomenthol and isoneomenthol. So there also this limonene acts as a ingredient, starting material for that. We will not see that pathway that we will limit it there, but limonene is an important ingredient in the citrus fruits, particularly in the peels of citrus fruits. Peels of citrus fruits means lemon, oranges, inke ya mosambi ke jo upar ke chhilke hote hain, in chhilko mein ye limonene compound very important to limonene compound wahan pe present rehta hai. This promotes weight loss as well as it prevents cancer. It is used in the treatment of cancer and also in the treatment of bronchitis. Limonene is having medicinal uses whereby it can be used. It is used for weight loss as well as for preventing cancer and for treatment of cancer and for the treatment of bronchitis. So limonene is an important ingredient medically also. It is very important. So this is how we synthesize limonene as well as alpha terpineol from menthyl cation. Menthyl cation can be utilized for that particular purposes. Similarly, menthyl cation can also be utilized for other different ways. Like we have, this is our menthyl cation. Now this menthyl cation can be can undergo cyclization, whereby this double bond can attack the cation. This double bond can attack the cation, and depending on which carbon of the double bond is attacking, there can be two different ways can be generated. If this is our A carbon and this is our B carbon of the double bond, if B carbon is attacking here, we will get a pinyl cation. If A carbon is attacking here, then we will get a boronyl cation. So if A is there, then we will get a boronyl cation. If B is there, then we will get a pinyl cation. So we can have different types of cations that can be generated from this menthyl cation. Draw a little bigger. So in this case, if A is attacking over here, so this will be molded inside the ring. So we will have a bond between these two via this carbon. That is, this and this will be bonded through this carbon. A will be bonded to this carbon, that is carbon possessing two methyl groups, and then that carbon will be attached to this one carbon over here. So there will be this double bond, and we will have a cation over here. And the B carbon will have a cation, will have a methyl group over here. This we call it as a boronyl cation. So this boronyl cation can be generated from menthyl cation. Similarly, if B is attacking over here, if B is attacking on this side, then we will get a bond between these two carbons. A bond between these two carbons where the dimethyl group is isopropyl group that we have it, where the two methyl groups will be over here, and we will have a double methyl attachment over the other side, and we will have a cation over here. This we will be calling it as a pinyl cation. So it can have two different fates, boronyl cation and a pinyl cation. Both of these will be giving rise to a range of many different compounds. Boronyl cation can have two different fates. One, it can undergo hydrolysis. Hydrolysis of this, we can have OH over here. So we call this as a borneol. This borneol, then we can represent this borneol as a bicyclic compound that we normally draw. Here this purple bond, here the dimethyl, and this will be giving rise to here. So this will be dimethyl. It is like this. What we are doing is like this. हमारा अभी ये जो बॉर्नियोल है यहाँ पर ये ऐसे ड्रॉ किया हुआ है और इसे हम ऐसे ड्रॉ कर रहे हैं. सो ये यहाँ पर ऊपर की तरफ आएगा. ये जो बीच वाला जो डायमिथिल जमीन कार्बन है, सो दैट विल बी कमिंग ओवर हियर अप. और यहाँ पे जो ये ब्रिज हेड पे मिथिल ग्रुप है एंड वी हैव हियर एज ए ओएच. सो दिस विल बी अवर बॉर्नियोल. दिस बॉर्नियोल कैन बी ऑक्सीडाइज्ड वेयर द we can get a ketone group, which we can represent it in this way also. This we call it as camphor. This is the camphor, how plants are synthesizing this camphor from borneol cation or from methyl cations. From methyl cation we can generate this borneol cation very easily. This is one fate of this borneol cation. The second can be a Wagner-Mirwin rearrangement, or we call it as Wagner-Mirwin shift. This is capital M, Wagner-Mirwin shift. The borneol cation can undergo 1-2 Wagner-Mirwin alkyl shift. So what happens here is that this bond will be shifted. This particular bond will be shifted to this carbon. That is, from here, this carbon is attached to here. Now, instead of attaching over here, it will be attached to this carbon. So it will just be shifting from this one position to two position. Let this be our one position. This is as a two position. So this carbon. Let us nomenclate this as 3, this as 4, 5 and 6. So, 6th carbon, now when it is attached to 1st carbon, now it will be shifting from its 1st carbon to a 2nd carbon. So, that we call it as 1-2 shift. It is shifting from 1st carbon to 2nd carbon. So, it will be a 1-2 shift will be happening. This type of rearrangements we call it as a 1-2 Wagner-Mirwin shifts. It can be 1-2 shifts, or it can be 1-3 shifts, or 1-4 shifts, depending on how the molecule is being arranged into it. So we can have this. We do not have that bond over there. So we have to draw it like this. This will be now shifted, and here we have the first carbon. This will be our group compound, where now this when it has shifted over here, this carbon will be having a cation. So this carbon we will have a cation. So this we call it as isocamphyl cation. Isocamphyl cation can be generated by 1-2 Wagner-Mirwin alkyl shift from borneol cation. So when this happens, we can draw this in a way where it is also a bicyclic compound. So this we can this we are showing it as a bridgehead. This if we nomenclate this into different ways, we have this as a 1, 2, 3. This has a 4, 5, 6, 7. And this has 8, 9, and 10 carbons. So here, what we can have is that this is our, say, 1. This will be our 2. This is 3. Then we have this as a 4, 5, 6 is attached to 1, but not to 5. So this is our sixth carbon, which is having a methyl group over here. So we will have a methyl as a seventh, and then this eighth will be having two methyl group. So this is our seventh carbon. This will be our eighth carbon, and 9 and 10 will be the two methyl groups. So we can draw it in this way, where our cation is on the sixth carbon. So here we will have a cation. जब भी आपको स्ट्रक्चर ड्रॉ करने में कुछ तकलीफ होती है तो वहां पे पहले स्ट्रक्चर पे नंबर्स डाल दो. दिस इज अ इजियर वे, और गलती नहीं होने के चांसेस यहाँ पे रहते हैं. मीन्स गलती नहीं होती है यहाँ पर, गलती होने के चांसेस कम होते हैं यहाँ पर. अगर आप नंबरिंग कर देते हो तो उस नंबरिंग के हिसाब से आप अपना स्ट्रक्चर वेरी इजिली निकाल सकते हो. सो दिस इज आइसोकैम्फिल कैटायन. दिस आइसोकैम्फिल कैटायन कैन बी क्वेंच्ड बाय लॉस ऑफ प्रोटॉन. So we will have this as a double bonded, and here we will have a loss of proton, so double bond. यहाँ पर हम नहीं कर सकते हैं, because ये अगर double bond हम करेंगे, loss of proton one carbon से होगा, तो यहाँ double bond आएगा 1-6 के बीच में, and then this one will be sp2 hybridized, which cannot happen because bridgehead carbons cannot have a sp2 hybridization. So that possibility is not there. The other side there are two dimethyl groups. No protons are there, so this side also double bond cannot happen. Other side also cannot happen. It is only this one possibility for that. So this compound we call it as camphene. So camphene can be generated from this isocamphyl cation, which is generated from boronyl cation by 1-2 Wagner Lewinship. So this is the fate of boronyl cation. How boronyl cation can be utilized for different compounds generation. Now we have this pinyl cations. Boronyl cation को हमने बनाया था A carbon का attachment, attack of A carbon से यहाँ पर isopropyl cation पर attack हुआ था, तब हमको boronyl cation मिला था. अगर B carbon attack करेगा तो we will get a pinyl cation. Now this pinyl cation then can be further utilized into different ways. The fate of this pinyl cation can be further different ways. One is loss of protons, but that loss of proton can be of different type. Here we cannot have a loss of proton. We can have a loss of proton in different ways. For this, we can have a A loss of proton, we can have B, or we cannot have C. C is not possible, because when C will be formed, it will be forming a double bond at this bridgehead carbon. Bridgehead carbon per double bond hamara allowed nahi hota hai. इसकी वजह से हमारा ये यहाँ पर नहीं चलेगा वो. सो दिस सी विल नॉट बी फॉर्म्ड, बट ए एंड बी लॉस ऑफ प्रोटॉन्स कैन हैपन. सो वी विल हैव वी कैन हैव अ लॉस ऑफ प्रोटॉन इन दिस वे, सो दैट ए लॉस प्रोटॉन, एंड दिस वी कॉल इट एज अल्फा पाइनिन. Similarly, we can have loss of proton over B side. Here A, here B. So if the loss of proton from B side is happening, then we will have a double bond here. That is exocyclic double bond we will get. This we call it as beta pinene. These are two important ingredients of pinenes, pinenes, alpha pinenes and beta pinenes. Then further, this cation can undergo again 1-2 Wagner-Mirvin. Alkyl shift. 1-2 Wagner-Mirvin alkyl shift can be happening in this. Yahan par, now if this carbon is shifted over B, if this carbon is shifted to B, we will get boronyl cation. Because that is what we are happening. If this carbon is shifting over here, it is as good as A is attacking the cation over here. So it will shift to boronyl cation. That we have already studied what happens to there. So we will shift this carbon to over here. So this particular bond is shifted towards this side in a 1-2 Wagner-Mirvin alkyl shift. this carbon bond will be shifting over the other side, so that this can be drawn outside and this will come inside. So we will have now we have this डायरेक्ट हम ऐसे नहीं ड्रॉ कर सकते हैं स्ट्रेट लाइन में, बिकॉज हमारा बीच में कार्बन, यहाँ पर हमने वो ड्रॉ किया था, बट यहाँ पर हमारे पास एक कार्बन ड्रॉ करने के लिए दो मिथाइल ग्रुप्स थे, यहाँ पर वो नहीं है, इसके लिए हम ये नहीं कर सकते। ऐसा भी हम ड्रॉ कर सकते हैं, फिर यहाँ पे हमें दो हाइड्रोजन बताने पड़ेंगे सी एच टू, तो दो हाइड्रोजन बता के हम कर सकते हैं, बट अदरवाइज दिस इज अ बेटर वे टू डू इट। देन वी हैव अ डबल डायमिथाइल ग्रुप्स ओवर हियर, देन वी हैव हियर एज अ कैटायन and we have a methyl group over here. So methyl group is there. Here we have a cation generated at C position. If we will get it, this we call it as a phenyl cation. This phenyl cation can undergo hydrolysis. To form an alcohol, we call it as phenyl alcohol. And further, this phenyl alcohol can be oxidized to form phenone. These compounds we can generate it from phenyl cation. Phenyl cations we can generate alpha phenyne, beta phenyne by loss of proton in either direction within the cycle, within the ring. If loss of proton happens, then alpha phenyne. If it is on outside the ring happens, then it is a beta phenyne. Then we have a 1-2 Wagner-Mirwin shift, whereby we can generate a phenyl cation, and that phenyl cation can further be hydrolyzed to phenyl alcohol and oxidized to phenone. So this is how phenyl cation can be quenched and boronyl cation can be quenched. There are further many different compounds are there where this phenyl cation can generate many different types of compounds, as well as the boronyl cation can also generate many different types of further compounds. Now, the important ones being thujone, which is used as a neurotoxic agent. Limonene se hame kafi sare dusre compounds milte hain, like menthol, isomenthol, then we can have neomenthol and neoisomenthol. Ye hamare cooling agents hote hain aur ek characteristic smell aati hai jo hamare FMCG industries में काफी काम में आते हैं। तो ये generally terpenes, particularly monoterpenes, ये बहुत सारे flavoring industries में काम में आते हैं। उनका हर compound का अपना अलग एक characteristic smell होता है, तो उसकी वजह से इनको हम generally use करते हैं अलग अलग industries में for giving rise to different characteristic smells over there. So this was for monoterpenes.